ready to match the stars. Edward Asner, Brent Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers!
Hello there.
Aren't they beautiful people?
Yes.
You're beautiful people.
Yes.
Shall we all play some fun and games now?
Of course, Eugenio.
You rascal. Mm-hmm. Let's say hello to our two players here, Phyllis Lear and R.P. Pound. Now, Phyllis Lear is our current champ. She's won one game, and she's got some money, $200, right?
Right.
And she's being challenged by R.P. Pounds here.
Not much.
But not much of a challenge, she says. Well, he had his question, and the first round questions are tough, and he didn't match any of our celebrities with it. And we'll see how Phyllis does with hers in a moment or so, right after this. I'm sorry, I'm not ready. I'll turn around when I'm ready. Now I'm ready. Oh, hello. Oh. I'm ready. Okay, I will push this button here and reveal the other first round question. This is for Phyllis. Everyone plays since it's her, it's a new game.
Yes.
Hey, did you hear about the big fight at Disneyland?
No!
No, let me tell you about the big fight at Disneyland. It was terrible. Mickey Mouse turned Donald Duck into a blank duck. Mickey Mouse turned Donald Duck into a blank duck.
I love it. Now that's easy. I like it simple.
Is that
simple,
a second round?
Straightforward. No, that's a first rounder.
Is it?
No. Yeah. Mickey Mouse turned Donald Duck a blank duck. All right, here we go. Phyllis Lear. A big fight at Disneyland, Phyllis. It was terrible. Mickey Mouse turned Donald Duck into a blank duck.
A dead duck?
Dead duck. That little girl said dead duck, Ed.
I know. I also note that Phyllis, and it seems most of our audience, postdates World War II. Unfortunately, that's the term I used, a ruptured duck.
Ruptured duck? It's a well-known phrase during World War II.
What did it mean?
Yeah. An airplane.
There was an airplane called a limping aircraft coming home to the roost.
I think we've got him out of trouble. Right.
A limping aircraft coming home. It sounds like the Jack Klugman story.
I said Dave.
That's one for her. What do you say?
I choked dead too, Gene.
You did indeed. The fight at Disneyland was terrible. Mickey Mouse turned Donald Duck into a dead duck. What do you say to that, little girl?
Dead does seem to be the answer everyone's going for.
Right.
I didn't.
Yeah. Well, I said dead, too.
Naturally. Three for her. Give it to the little girl. Yeah. Terrible.
Fight.
Oh, awful.
His last words.
Yes. Now, Miss Patty, honey.
Yeah?
I suppose you ain't got dead duck.
You got it.
What you got?
Well, see, Mickey Mouse was involved in the Oriental martial arts.
Oh.
And turned Donald into a press duck.
A press duck. Duck. Whoops, there. Oh, wait a minute. Don't nobody move.
You ruptured a duck over there?
No, hold up now. Don't nobody do nothing.
Martial arts.
I'll get it now. No, I won't get it. Well, there. Now that. Now hold everything. There. You want A or B, R.P.? What's A?
A.
You want A?
Don't give it to him. Have a commercial.
Oh, let's go to commercial while they fix the machine. Get down there. Down, down. What a commercial. Fix the machine. Here we go. Round two coming up. RP, you may have A or B.
A.
You want A. A.
What does RP stand for?
RP stands for RP. It's no middle, you know, it's just nothing.
I don't believe that.
That's what he says.
Is it Rachel? Are you ashamed of it?
No.
Well, what is it, do you think?
He said no. Robert Peter Pounds.
RP.
That's enough of that. Now. Now, Ted said, I think my wife secretly wanted to marry a surgeon. Every night, when I come to bed, she makes me wear blank.
Uh-oh.
You seem nonplussed.
Is that the word?
Nonplussed. Splendid, splendid, splendid. Good. Okay. RP, are you ready?
Yep.
All right, don't say it yet, son. As soon as Ed's got his light going there, we'll do it.
Go, Big Daddy.
Okay, Ted said, I think my wife secretly wanted to marry a surgeon. Every night when I come to bed, she makes me wear...
Mask.
A surgical mask. Listen, some of these weirdos up here may say that. Hello, Ed.
You bet your tuchus.
Hey, Surgeon Smith. That's one.
Well, I wear a surgical mask when I just visit a sick friend, so I didn't say that. I said he wore his scalpel.
Wore a scalpel?
Thing. Don't boo me. I'm not well, and I haven't smoked for a long time. I'm a mother.
Here, here, here. What do you say, Charles?
There are charm schools in the country you can go to.
I had a governor.
I said rubber gloves. Rubber gloves.
Now, RP, you've got to match everybody down here in the lower tier to stay in the game. Marianne, it's up to you. Looking for a mask.
You said there would be some ding-a-lings who'd match it. Isn't that what you
said? Yes, I said that. There's one. Score is now 4-2. Got to match Richard.
What's RP stand for now, Mr. Pounds? I can help you out. We must come to term.
Rooster Pepper.
What? Pardon?
Rooster Pepper.
Rooster Pepper.
All right, I'll buy that this time.
Now, help out that good old Rooster Pepper boy there, honey.
Do those near and dear to you call you R?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, then I said in surgical type mask.
So the score is tied at this moment. Phyllis, all you have to do is match one celebrity, and you have won your second game. Here it is. Edward plays, and who else? And
yes.
Patty plays. Okay, here we go. Horrible Hannah said, she said, I think the reason Marvin fell in love with me is that he works in a garbage dump. You see, Marvin likes the way my blank smells.
First, you don't succeed.
I think the reason Marvin fell in love with me is that he works in a garbage dump. Marvin likes the way my blank smells. Put something on the card, and I'll walk over here to Phyllis Lear.
Thank goodness I don't write.
All right.
Oh, he's a wonderful help.
Okay, Phyllis. Horrible Hannah said, I think the reason Marvin fell in love with me is that he works in a garbage dump. You see, Marvin likes the way my blank smells.
My breath smells.
One foul breath wins the game for her.
It'll have to be somebody else. I said cooking.
My cooking.
I like that.
Cooking. All right. Yes. Breath is what she wants.
I know what she wants, but I was hanging out with him. I said leftovers.
Leftovers. So that means this game ends in a tie.
Wow.
And when that happens, we have to kind of start all over again. Blow a fuse here and turn off all those numbers. Push this button here. Reveal one tie-breaking question for each. The one who matches the most celebrities will be the winner. And R.P., we're going to start with you.
I'll take A.
You want A? You got it, R.P.
Jamar.
What's that?
Paul Amar.
R. Okay, R. That's
right. He's been here a while.
Very familiar. R, listen to this. Jacques Cousteau said to the scientist, to the psychiatrist, I beg your pardon.
How many fingers do I have?
I'm trying to watch it with one eye, you see. It's very difficult to have one eye there, one eye here. Jacques Cousteau said to the psychiatrist, he says, here, well, you may think I am crazy, but I have fallen in love with a blank.
Jacques Cousteau said
to the psychiatrist, you may think I'm crazy, but I have fallen in love with a blank.
Oh, there's so many choices. Criminy Dutch. Gravy Marie.
Well, now think about Jacques Cousteau. Hold everything. What's that?
Who's that? Jacques Cousteau, whatever.
Mark Breslow, would you stop the music for a second? What did you say?
I don't know who that Jacques Cousteau is.
If you kiss me, I'll tell you.
That works out because, you know, he doesn't know who you are either.
That's right.
I'll tell you what.
Jacques Cousteau is a famous underwater scientist. He does a lot of work with natural life underwater and exploring underwater world and the habitats of fish and the way they live and that sort of thing. Have you ever seen any of his stuff on television or any of the Jacques Cousteau movies? Well, he's a guy with the water dripping out of his ears. I don't know what else to tell you there. Would you,
sir,
we're doing all this for you. Okay.
Oh, I'm finished.
Anyway, this famous underwater scientist said to the psychiatrist, you may think I am crazy, but I have fallen in love with a...
Dolphin.
A dolphin.
Yeah.
A dolphin. Okay. George C. Scott would have fallen in love with a dolphin. Jacques Cousteau fell in love with
a fish.
With a fish. A fish. What do you say?
I remember that wonderful program he did on the octopi. I said he fell in love with an octopus.
An octopus. Charles?
Je réponds en français.
Oui.
Je dis une mademoiselle de mer. Which is a mermaid for you people.
A mermaid, yes.
Which is a stinky answer in either language.
It's a very touching, beautiful answer.
I like mermaid.
Jacques Cousteau said to me, you think I'm crazy, but I've fallen in love with a...
Oh, what the heck. A whale.
A whale.
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 You can make up your mind about that, huh?
Octopus.
Octopus. And?
Solamandine to go.
Solamandine to go. So hold everything here now. We've got to do a little business with America, and then we'll see how you do with a tiebreaker. Come back. Hello. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. You. Now, what you have to do is match one celebrity, and you've won your second game. Here we go.
I just want to announce I'm getting engaged to that lovely Debbie who... I kissed
Sweet
during
girl.
The commercial.
He kissed a girl during the commercial.
I've fallen in love with her.
Yes.
Debbie.
Now, that's not what I want you to write.
Oh, well, here's my answer anyway. Debbie.
Are you listening, Phyllis? Are you listening?
Yes, I am now.
Instead of birth control pills...
Debbie, I love you.
Instead of birth control pills, Gloria took yeast tablets. Now, wait a minute, that's not the question. Don't laugh until we do the whole thing here. Instead of birth control pills, Gloria took yeast tablets. 9 months later, she gave birth to a 6-pound blank.
Oh.
Okay.
What was her name?
Debbie.
No, no, darling. The man in the question
is Gloria. His friend is Debbie.
Debbie.
Yeah.
You got to keep your mind on your work, Richard.
Okay.
All right. Writing Charles.
Come on, Debbie.
All right, now we're ready. Phyllis. Instead of birth control pills, Gloria took yeast tablets. Are you listening to me?
I was looking at Charles, who's just writing and writing.
I ain't writing. There's something wrong with his jack.
Now listen to me.
I will.
Look at me.
I
it
will.
Helps. When I'm speaking to you, I like to have eyeball contact.
Okay.
All right. Instead of birth control pills, Gloria took yeast tablets. 9 months later, she gave birth to a 6-pound blank.
Red.
Okay. You've got your Debbie? And I, what do you say?
What do you got?
What? I've got you, Ed. It's you and me.
It's out. Sorry, kid. I went a different route than Brad. I said a 6-pound beer.
Yeast is one of the primary ingredients of beer.
Yeast is one of the primary ingredients of beer.
Show us yours.
Oh, well, why not? Loaf of bread.
Loaf of bread wins the day. Loaf of bread.
Okay, come on down.
All right. You know where to stand. Right over there, my dear. And I'll get to you in a moment or so. RP! We've got a lot of gifts for you, and I think some of you may even enjoy. But it was a great pleasure meeting you and having you here on Match Game 77. So long, RP! Here we go again. Now, this is your second time up here. You know how it goes. We polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Square blank. Remember, it's $500 if you match the answer they gave most often. $250 for the second most popular and $100 for the third. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Square dance.
Square dance is one.
Brett.
Square root.
Square root.
Charles.
Let me see, dear.
Square peg in a round hole.
Square peg in a round hole, square dance, and square root are the three. You can choose one or reject them all and give us one of your own.
Oh, I'm going to go with square dance.
Square dance is what we want. Let's see if we get any dancing under there, up there under the $100 response. Square deal. Yes. Okay.
That was
square dance, group. Square dance. Are you under the $250 response? No, that was Brett's answer. Last chance for square dance. Slide it. Yes, congratulations. Very good. You got another $500. You got $800 all together now, and you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000, and you got to match one person to get it.
Richard.
Okay, here
well,
we
I'm
go.
Playing for two.
Good luck to you, my dear. Get your extrasensory perception going, your psi phenomena, and you'll get the money. It's worth $5,000. Mission blank. Mission blank. Okay, Phyllis, what answer do you want to give us? We think we'll match his. In this case, you get the $5,000 if you match.
I don't have anything.
Mission.
I don't have anything for mission. I just went blank.
Well, now just look at it for a second and think. Mission blank.
All I can think of is a church.
Mission church.
I just didn't
know. Yeah, mission is a church. Okay.
I just couldn't think of anything.
Couldn't think of anything. Richard, show her an answer.
Bum, 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 bum.
Mission impossible.
Oh, we thought that was going to be a shoe-in for you. I'm sorry, my dear. Well, you've picked up a little extra money, and you're going to play another game later. Right now, this for you. Listen, next time we get together, these are the bodies that'll be on the stage.
Mel Tillis, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Bonnie Franklin, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg.
Thank you all, you were splendid. Johnny, that's time for that game 77. Jimmy, goodbye.